I'm back in Scotland for this one. This is Glencoe, lovely part of the world. I'm using 15 by 11 watercolour paper, large Ron Ranson hake, and this is there's some misty mountains. This is just raw sienna, just a hint of ultramarine. Now I'm going ultramarine, a bit of Pine's Grey. Right now, starting with the mountains, I'm mixing the same colours again, raw sienna, ultramarine, bit of Pine's Grey, just mixing the lot together, and then we're right up there. Well, so that's going to be the top. Now I'm going to strengthen it as we come down. So we're going to have some water along here. So because I've got those in wet, you can see how it's give it that misty look. It's sort of disappearing off into the horizon. You can hardly see on this side at all. But as you get down to the foothills, I can see a bit of grass. So I'm just adding a bit of lemon yellow to the mix. So as we come down towards where there's a road coming across there, so I'm just going to stop. I'm just going to stop short of where the road is, the ending, because I want a chisel edge to the brush as we're starting to separate. So that's a little road running across there. Now on this side, that's all I'm going to do for that side there. Now the water starts there, so just put a bit more on this, these foothills on this side, just try and make it a little bit more interesting. A little bit darker. A bit of light red in there, but not too much, so it'll quickly dominate. And obviously by making this a bit darker, it sort of emphasises how light the top is. For the paper stretch, I'm just going to pull it tight again. I'm going to put the water in next, I think, or at least wet this area and get some reflections in. So I'm using a plain brush. And without touching the land, just wet that. Now you get a strong mix, same colour as the hills, roughly, it doesn't have to be exact. I'm just going to come in from the side, I think. Bit darker. Little bit on this side. So I've just tried to preserve that little bit of light where the light's catching the water. And where the water's gathered at the bottom, just soak that up with the brush. That's all I'm going to do with the reflection. I'm just going to dry that. Next, so we've got our little road going across there. There's just a little bit of land you can see on the far side over there. It's just raw sienna with a touch of pine's grey. Maybe a bit of lemon yellow as well. A bit more raw sienna. I just want to preserve that lighter area there because that's the road. What's that? There. I can start doing a few more broader sweeps. That's it there, right there. Touch a light red, just to liven it up a bit. Not so much. Very easy to overdo it with a light red. And then as we come into the foreground, you can see lots of grassy areas, so I'm just going to sweep that round. I'm just going to keep varying the colour to make it keep it interesting. few grass down here, I'm just flicking off. It's very light. Flicks just to suggest some grasses and whatnots in there. I'm going to put a real dark area down here, I think. Seems like a good place to have some rocks. I'll try and keep it subtle though, I don't want to. It's so hard to resist doing them. Big one over here going off the page. I'm going to switch to the number 3 rigger. Just doing a very weak mix, could be absolutely any, mix anything. I'm just doing burnt umber, ultramarine. Quite weak, don't want it very strong. I'm just going to put some birds on this side, I think. I'll do it for that. And then, same mix, a little bit stronger. And I'm going to sign that one and call it finished. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.